welcome along to this YouTube channel that's giving you the Ariana DeBose wrap of insight in the BAFTA Awards show of cultural discourse, hopefully without the devastating social media backlash. I'm back from Berlin, where the Golden Bear winner was Nicolas Philibert's On the Adamant, a thoroughly worthwhile choice, a documentary about a floating daycare centre in Paris for people with psychological disorders. Berlin was actually very interesting, and I hope soon to return to my favourite movie there, Tina Satter's Reality, about the arrest of the American whistleblower and intelligence operative, Reality Winner. Belgian filmmaker Lucas Dont has had an avalanche of praise and a Niagara of emotional tears for his new film Close, about the unselfconscious love and friendship between two 13-year-old boys.
Mais pourquoi tu dis ça?
Parce que ça nous tente trop.
Enfin, je sais pas.
Bah, on s'est rapprochés parce qu'on est
sûr et certain.
I admit that there are times when Dont goes straight for the deafening minor chords of anguish, but there are two excellent performances here from newcomers Gustave Devalle and Aidan Dombrin as Rémy and Léo, and also valuable appearances from the actors playing their mothers, particularly Sophie, played by Émilie Dequesne, iconic for the lead in the Dardenne brothers' 1999 Cannes Palme d'Or winner Rosetta, when she was hardly older than the boys are now. Rémy and Léo are inseparable friends, hanging out together and playing together all the time. Physical, tactile, joyful and innocent, and certainly far more intense than most 13-year-olds. Léo is especially close to Rémy's mum and is physically at ease with her. Schoolmates suddenly become aware of the intensity of their friendship, and a terrible moment comes when some girls, who are perhaps honest or perhaps malicious or perhaps just somewhere between the two, ask Léo if he and Rémy are a couple, and with malign ersatz sophistication, they ask if Léo even realises it. And it is this painful and destructively sly implication of something unconscious, something which they airily claim to be there without his knowledge, which is arguably the single most culpable moment in this tragic drama. Soon the boys are starting to make mean remarks to Léo, who is angry, scared and humiliated. He withdraws from Rémy, blanks him in the playground, goes in for macho ice hockey. Rémy is deeply baffled and wounded. Léo can hardly bear Rémy's mute, and then not mute, reproach, and with being confronted with his own fickle dishonesty. The story of Close is disturbing because however wised up teenagers probably are now about the language of relationships and LGBT issues, compared to the relative naivety of maybe even just 10 years ago, the breakup of an intense friendship is shocking. There is still none of the adult life experience to explain it away, and the end of a friendship is devastating in the way that a romantic relationship's end probably isn't. For Rémy, Léo's sudden decision to break up with him has the same effect of his mother deciding to put him up for adoption, or the son not coming up in the morning. It's a violent, unspeakably painful rupture that Rémy does not have the language to explain to himself. He is perhaps mature in a way that Léo is not. Perhaps he is outraged at what amounts to a disloyal capitulation to homophobia or bullying, or perhaps it is not a question of being mature. He is just upset, or more than upset. There's no doubting the force of this drenchingly sad story. So that's it. Please give this humble vlog a like and a share on your immensely influential social media platforms. Please check out my author homepage at The Guardian. And of course, please, oh please, join the family of enlightened souls and subscribe to this channel. And leave an almost fanatically supportive comment once you have done so. And please, buy my book, The Films That Made Me, an edited selection of my essays and reviews for The Guardian. See you next time.